Hello again. We're going to try this one more time, hopefully with stability this time. Let's open the seal once again. Okay, once more into the ruined passage. My fault, I feel pretty bad. Why I'm going to try ever harder to restabilize things and make it all work out anyhow. What's down here? Okay, just the other path from before, like I was expecting. Thank you. light and dark seals. Sensible enough. Wood too. Guess there might be one for each element in here. That would make sense. So I guess most, if not all, of those are just going to hide stuff. Everything. At least I still have gummy frogs. Like it makes much sense for there to be ghosts down there where there's nothing obstructing me and right, I had a yawn going there. There's also no gaps for those posts to be crossing, but soon enough I'm going to change the layout of that room in a way where those posts are going to become relevant. I really like how leveled out this build has become, just overall. And again, this is pretty similar to how I built in Final Fantasy Adventure too. Focused on both of these stats that would give you physical or magic defense, while attack and magic still got some gain. Power's the one I want. Thank you. make sure I had the right accessory on. I remember using magic for a bit earlier. And I would rather prefer to be using the one that's stronger, as opposed to the one that's not stronger. Because, I'm not doing any casting right now, so... Strength rather than int. Weapon back where it should be. Getting some rather fortunate materials out here. Could I be able to get one more chance at doing a hothouse work? On we go. For suddenly technology. Looks like we're going down first. Guess, because that's just a passage around to a chest. unless it was part of it I was missing. Didn't see. It's also the only way.
Okay.
That's touchable. May or may not have done something up here. Okay, that opened the door down here. And now we have a warbot. Seems much more useful than Dingus. You to examine the thing. Wow, wow, wow. Nature spirit free time. Thank you. I figured that would probably mean I would need to use Dryad magic, but apparently not. Let's just go right back to the previous floor. I'm going to guess that the oldest one is the highest elevation, second elevation, and so on. New one. Back to you. They light up after a specific amount of hits, so that's what defines which one is which, not perceived elevation or anything like that. For some reason, the puzzle did not reset. Get out of here. I have to go around to the other staircase. Was they light up after a different amount of hits, and you have to have them all lit up. Fire. burning. There we go. They're just chests out here. Yeah. So I need to find a way to get over onto that crazy platform. Because long-range weapons won't work. Unless I can use staff special. Hype and attention for the night with all of that shenanigans, but no. Can't really do anything about it. I guess I have to hit the button by each pile of bodies based on how many are in the pile. Robert. Up here, and more tower falls away. Across we go. Thank you. Would you not? I'm not dying to getting cornered by a couple of you. Have something to say about this one? Or yellow tiles, I guess. Hello. I'm sorry about earlier, but things certainly seem okay now. I don't know what was going on, but since trying again, I've had zero dropped frames, so at the very least, it seems to be much better now. You stop that. I need you to not just like stay in iframes constantly so I can hit you. Matt. Can't you be that cooperative? Darn. Just missed the safe. This tower is long, but it's just some silly puzzles. Very loose puzzles. Apparently I need to kill these. Huh? Shelf stable. confusing. They let you go over to that platform where the enemies over there are, but there's no point because they can only be damaged by magic anyway. They might as well just cast at them from afar. Yeah, if I hadn't done the puzzles in the last three rooms, that would be the door that doesn't open. The result. As you get higher up this place, it crumbles behind you. I think this is a boss time, so might as well drop another save after the cutscene puzzle stuff. Robot is friend. This is cool, but not particularly threatening, mostly because it doesn't try to wombo combo you. Defense down could be a problem, though. This thing is basically Wizari. And it's over. That same kind of this seems threatening, but once you realize that what it's doing is not really enough to kill you on its own, it's not a problem anymore. Thank you. can just cut a shadow like that. Turn it, Poto. I've seen her jump, she can't make it that far. Robot is cool. The most emotional attachment to any character I've had in this game. Alright, Dingus, let's go. The track in this area is very weird, but I also like it a lot. Anyway, before that, we have one last end of game hothouse. Why? Because they gave you a bunch of materials in the previous dungeons, and they gotta give you some place to use them. I'm not giving him seeds because I think I'll be back sometime to take the harvest, but because I'm not going to be back, I think he deserves to have final seeds before we go. Be a hungry tree. You can even have the spinies. Can toss two into you. Okay then, let's pop the cactus before we go. Granted, he's probably still writing about things from halfway through the game because it queues up the entries in this one rather than only giving you the most recent one. Petrified near those is an issue because they can then explode. Played this, the left and right just a loop this point until you decide to go up if you're supposed to. Totally okay with it. Flash then? Flash is less ineffective. I'll kill this one just to see how long it takes, but they are very not worth the time, it looks like. Story is below. This one will loop till you take the right way, I think. Anyone that's not right has these little sparkly particles by them. Spirit doesn't. If there's anything else on the screen. Gummy frog and taco. At this point, they seem to have realized that there's nothing they can give us that you can use other than consumables. Mostly, debilitating statuses are just wastes of time at this point. They don't do anything but make you have to wait longer to finish things off. Hagen type. I'm just not bothering with traps anymore because they're trying to disarm them safely because there's only one okay on the whole thing. Tell me you can't bash a mushroom. I've done it. which way? Get over here. Is axe effective on you? Oh yeah, this is much more effective. Mute the light foot. This part of the dungeon is probably going to take a little while to get through, because it's just an unmarked maze, rather than something where you have to take a clearly marked exit. Well, I was wrong about them being smart enough not to give us things we can't use anymore. Because they are indeed giving us more, seeds and materials. You would have to run all the way out of the dungeon to utilize stuff like that anymore. These fish are pretty easy to kill, so they're gonna get the heck. Fortunately, not actually a dangerous trap, just like all of them. Thank you. Here we go. Set piece room. Four dragon. Good. Burns you. Hey, hey. You're not allowed to just repeatedly fire me while I can't do anything about it. That was awkward. I got immobilized, but I could still pound on him. Like most bosses, it doesn't take long to kill, but it can do some kind of annoying cheese thing that can kill you before you can kill it, if you're not careful. Just got a mercy revive after the fight, so I imagine I might as well heal him so he can squander it again. This place is not trivial. Just in terms of its size. Even though it mostly uses the same tile set, it does have things that help you keep a decent sense of direction and location and landmarks. You didn't have that nearly so much in FFA Final Dungeon. Because imagine that it was multiple generations older. Get the fungus. I want to say this place is still at least mostly linear. It's just that the linear path is not exactly a one that feels like a succinct path through the place. Just in general, it's very windy and diverts you down little side things rather than obvious places to go through. Well, as long as you don't start going back the way you came, we'll get through it fine enough. then you eventually come to a dead end and start thinking about where you missed another path. Well, it's a step up from the originals, and the final dungeon in FFA was just really big and meandering. And this one is big and meandering, but it has set pieces of things that give you a sense of direction. Whereas FFA was limited to where it could only have, like, square screens that might have a few objects in it, but that's about it. So they definitely do a good job of helping you get, like, oriented, but it's still a lot of samey tiles. There's a lot of cracked pillar, fallen pillar, and mossy wall. But much like the original, it's just something to give you some extra levels with enemies that aren't actually very threatening. Unfortunately, there is not a set of ultimate armor out here, because this game doesn't do armor drops. Yeah, that's basically everywhere in Sanctuary, to be honest. We are at the point where not getting hit by traps is for losers. Getting hit by traps is the cool kid thing to do. It's definitely samey and easy to lose track of. Like, I'm at a fork here. I'm gonna forget there's a fork here. I'm gonna take a path, try to go down it. When it doesn't lead anywhere, I'll feel lost till I get back here. Like, oh yeah, there was an entire path down to the bottom left there. Never mind, these aren't doors. Why aren't these doors? I suppose most of the reason why I'm not, like, worried about the fact that everything looks the same is because I've done this before and I know what's going on. Okay, this is the same as the other room where I fought that other boss. Does that mean I've looped back around? No. This means they wanted to reuse this set piece, and also you're at a dead end. Like, the other one, you come in from the bottom and leave to the right. This one, you come in from the right and leave to the bottom. Exact same room, though. It feels like you've just gone back out the front door. It definitely does. Like, how in the world did I get looped back around to the front? But no, this is just a different out front alike area. I think. I haven't completely ruled out that I am in fact lost, and did in fact go all the way back to the start. Whether or not I'm bluffing about not being worried because I know exactly what this part of the dungeon is like is entirely up to you. Okay, let's do a thing here. Just stack up the fish and ruin them. How dare. No, I might have actually just made my way back out. I might be almost dead and unable to do anything about it. Check me, dingus. Actually have completely looped myself back around and outside. Never mind, I have no idea what I'm doing. Confirmed. I was pretty sure that once you get to the inside part, there's a spot where you go back outside. Now this was the two sides room that just had chests, nothing else to do. And you go to the right, and that's where the door is. Alright, back semi on track, question mark. Get out of here, fish. I need to find where I got turned around. That's a down. That's an up. I'm gonna go down. Pretty sure I went up last time. I don't know why I'm still opening chests. I guess to make sure that whenever I see chests, I know I'm somewhere new. Okay. This might have been what I was thinking about. all these materials that I don't have an opportunity to use without going all the way back out to the start. I'm not gonna do. I don't know why I suddenly feel a need to keep Dingus alive, because literally not important. I wonder if this place is gonna have ninjas, because FFA definitely had ninjas. This looks like a point where one might get lost. They don't do the right thing. Honey elixir. That's good. I can go down to a door there. If I go over here, yeah, I think this is what the problem is. I think that is the other branch, like if I had gone upstairs instead of downstairs, they both converge here, where you're supposed to go down here. Never mind, this isn't a door. Let's assume I'm not wrapping up around to the other path, then, and see what lies over this way. I'm relatively somewhat sure that this is not back out near the door where I first came in. Somewhat assured that this is a new outdoor region, and what I was actually thinking of all along. Pretty sure it's near where the final save point is. I go over to the right, I go in that door, the safe point, and then the boss. possibly more dungeon before then. But yeah. This place, turns out, does definitely have some tricks. You know, the first part was a wandering maze where you have to take the correct path or it'll loop you back. And the correct path is the one that doesn't have the sparkly stuff by its exit. Then you have the, like, outside temple region, which is just stuff to do. And then you get inside, and it's... I'm not 100% sure what happened in there, but it feels like there's a big circle, and somewhere on that big circle is a tangent to where the true path is. This should be it. This cutscene is always, you know, it's very much an exhibition of major cliche, but I still like it a lot whenever it comes up. The, like, 3 times I've watched it, I think the way they actually present it is really decent. This is a very exciting cutscene battle. then they bookend it with that really, really tired, boring line. That's a hero's strong suit, lessening any cutscene he's a part of by filling it with the worst character in the game. He takes awful stupid to an all new degree. Yay. Sword duo shiny. Whatever, enough with your burning shenanigans. Easy phase? Hard phase? Stop it. Healing you, fool. This is a good just whenever he do a shiny, get away. But easy once you get it. I'm beginning to wonder if Staff Charge might be able to, like, at least half kill the final boss. Vaguely remember this already. It's neat, but annoying. He's got like a lot of different colored phases that all do their own attack. And physical doesn't work right now. Fine with that. I will gladly do one repeatedly instead. This may be back to physical, yes. They are doing that thing that bosses in this game do way too much, where they just float back and forth across the screen without doing any attacks, and it's really boring. Cutscene attack. Was this going to be force damage or have something that I have to avoid? The answer is force damage. If you were not absolutely capped off when that went off, the heck with you. Start over. When are you even vulnerable? I guess when you're doing your... that. Bye-bye. Don't cut it out. Oh no, I might be dead. He's doing the thing and I am not fully capped on health. Game design. So who wants to do that entire cutscene again? You know, the like several minute one? So how are you doing today? Yeah, there are a lot of bits about the actual design of the engine that are just not good. Like, when you get hit, you are interrupted for an amount of frames that is usually right about equal to how often an enemy is liable to repeat attacks on you. That is further broadened by how much startup delay there is on an attack. Like, you just holding your weapon out, preparing a swing, rather than, like, before it actually contacts. Which varies wildly by weapon, too. So a lot of things can just hit you and hit you and hit you, and the only thing you can do is, you do usually have a decent window to run away. That's the main saving grace of it, but generally speaking, the frame data favors the enemy far more often than it favors you. And I guess that is their way to get around the fact that enemies aren't dangerous. But that just makes it not fun in two different ways at once, because the enemies aren't dangerous, they're just irritating because they keep hitting you and you can't hit back. While they're, you know, mashing you for one over and over and over. And they can do that out of your own combo. The three-hit combo for sword and staff and I guess anything with a combo. Sorry, I keep bumping the mic because I'm not used to it being close to me now. Usually there's an extra wind-up between the second and third hit, but the second hit doesn't have the extra hit stun to accommodate making sure you have the window to get that hit in. So it's very, very easy to get interrupted out of your own combo, which makes no sense at all. Doubly so if your second attack misses. Because that just makes it even more free for them to get a hit in on you. But yeah, for how much, like, incredible amount of concept and neat, like, design things there are in this game, there's just about as much actual in-practice design that's just not very good. Like, they have seriously added so much to add, like, extra depth and layers and purpose to different things. But that's completely countered by the fact that the base experience just isn't very fun to do very often. Like, when it works for you, it's fine, but it very often is engineered to not work for you. Like, I would be fine if we started here. Like, if there was a save point after that first cutscene, where you just can go in the door and fight the boss, that would have been cool. That would be fine. I would have no problems there. Other than the fact that it's a point of no return there. So, like, I guess they would need a save point there and a way to hop back. Like, even this is a lot of cutscene to redo, just this dialogue with Julius. But that on top of the 5-minute preamble, you know, everybody's hearts are with you thing. Yeah, that would be cool. Like, if that can't kill you because of the sword or something, but it puts you at one and you're immediately at risk of getting killed. Like, that's really the problem with bosses more than anything in this game, like, overall. They don't have enough health to actually make you care about dealing with their attacks. They accommodate for that by making them do too much damage, so that if you don't do it right, you just die. You can very easily get bursted down on basically any boss. We'll be right back. I like this attack, where you have to figure out where he ended up to know where the attack's gonna come from for real, but it takes too long to resolve for it to actually, you know, have that aspect of prediction and twitch reaction. Like, if he quickly created 8 images and you had to detect which was the last one that came up to know where the attack was coming from, that could be cool. But when they appear, like, a full second between each one, and they resolve with a full second between each one, and then he starts doing the first part of a long attack, once the others resolve, there's nothing to that. That is just there to be there. It's like a director said, you need to have the attack be like this. And then the person actually programming the fight said, okay, now it has this. But they just had the absolute basic to fit that requirement and nothing else. Not being poisoned. Stop being not hitting. This is the magic. I'll entertain it. No, I won't. I do one. Just wait for the switchback. Not that. You are a There we go. That's some. Is suddenly very fast. He's actually caught up with the damage I've been doing to him. Is just take the first 2 hits and don't care, and then after that we are not going to entertain the poison, and after the second hit wakes you up from the sleep of the first one, completely erasing any challenge that might have been encountered, you run away from the third hit and heal, and you're perfectly safe. So I'd just like to say that the impact of that heal is very not cool or, believable. way to prove that the only reason I lost the first time is because I had probably missed a couple too many hits. In time for you to do a second cycle of your garbage attack, and I. That's not a good boss, but it's like a lot of bosses in that game. They just kind of float. They have these flying enemies that just float around the top of the screen and don't do anything to you for long periods of time, and then eventually they'll do some kind of lame swooping attack that hits you once and isn't really actually threatening. Last words are just, alright, I'm off. Very, profound. He's oof. Overall, my feeling with this game is there's so much potential for something cool here, but the last time I said that was with FFL3. And that game got a really low rating because they've name-dropped so many games, they're even name-dropping games that aren't out yet. The narrator says Dawn of Mana, I'm tossing him out the window. But the problem with FFL3 was it had a lot of wasted potential, and it dragged it down to the point where the game just wasn't enjoyable for the most part. It was mostly wrestling against the mechanics to try to keep it relatively stable. That's not really true here. It's more just, like, mildly irritating because of the little things that drag it down over what is otherwise still a pretty good experience. So I feel like the total for this game is still over average, but not much. Maybe average, I'm not sure. it's really close to neutral, possibly a little above neutral. Most of what draws me to the game is I really like the idea of its stat growth and class system. Is your O key having a problem? If the game didn't have a cool system of being able to, like, put together your own build for your character, I probably would not be nearly as invested in it. Like, that really is one of the things that draws me to it the most. Also, as an aside, the classes themselves with the bonuses, not actually very important. They're good bonuses, especially if you pick ones that play well into how you want to build your character, but like many of the things, it's like, yeah, this could be a nice added bonus, but it's entirely not necessary. Like, the geodes to increase the total level of your spells, and let's see, what other things? The crafting and tempering system. Those are all like, yes, this is a decent benefit that gives a very visible increase to my potential output, but it's completely not necessary. Like, you could go the entire game without taking the classes, especially not going after very specific, most beneficial ones. You could go through the whole game with the basic weapons, and it wouldn't really change much, because the growth from stats still really dominates how you build and how that build comes to fruition. They're just like a bunch of little additors that, yes, they are... You can demonstrably show that they are increasing your character's potential, but they aren't necessary. It's like, the feeling that they're so very, like, extra, and not, like, major parts of creating and building your character is part of what makes those feel underutilized or unrealized, I suppose. So there's just, like, a lot of little things that they added, but didn't put enough into to make it worth really being there. Like, compare it to, this is a totally out of left field example, but compare it to, like, the blacksmithing in RS3. That's a completely not required inside and stuff, but you get very clear and decent and steady major increases out of fostering that and growing it as much as you can. It's not so here. Like, all the other systems are just there. You don't really have to do anything. You're completely fine if you ignore them. They give you bonuses, but they're just bonus. It's not like... It's not going to change the world or anything. Anyway. I guess that was mostly the thing. Like, this game takes a lot from every other mana game. And that's fine. You know, it's a remake. It, you know, it nods a lot to itself and not just the game it's remaking. And that's good and fine and honestly preferable. But I felt like they kind of had too many cooks going on. Like, they had to add every single thing. By the time they added every single thing they planned to have in, it was just kind of a mess of too many things. Like, we're going to inject all these other characters for no incredibly important reason other than to have them there because they were in the series and stuff like that. Like, the SD3 villains that they put in, they didn't really have a reason or purpose for doing that. Their characters could easily be completely written out of the game and nothing of particular substance would change. Like, they're just there to say things indicative of what their character is like, and that's about it. But anyway, I've basically said all that I think about the various rights and wrongs with the game already. I would just be, you know, going on about things as I tend to do at the end of games. So I'm gonna cut myself short there, because it would just be reiteration and needless expansion of thoughts. But yeah. I'm sorry about the really bad internet hiccuping I had earlier. I don't know what was wrong, but I just gave it a little while and it was fine. But it was completely untenable at the time. It's alright. It passed. That's what's important. Anyway, tomorrow is getting into RS1 Remake. I don't know too much about it, what's different and what's the same and all that, so it'll actually be interesting to me to go in fresh and basically blind on it, other than my experience with the first game, to see what happens. But yeah, that should be neat. I'm looking forward to having that as a blind comparison piece compared to, like, this, where I already knew the game fairly well because I played through it several times. But yeah, that'll be tomorrow. Hopefully it'll go well. Hopefully it'll be more conducive to progress than the first one was. But yeah. As always, I want to thank everybody for coming out. It's always nice to have people around and everything. You know, as I always say, but I don't just say it to have, like, a sign-off or something. I say it because I really do appreciate not just playing games by myself, you know, having people to hang out with. I'm not a very, like, socially articulate and active person, and this is kind of like my way to have people around for what would otherwise just be sitting by myself and, you know, not doing anything other than plodding away at a game and probably not finishing it. But yeah. Thanks for coming out, everybody. I hope to see you again next time. Have a nice evening. And take care. Oh, a thing is happening. Hold on. Hello, Kokobo. Bye. Did that happen in the first one? I think that happened in the first one. But yeah. I already said my sign off. Good night. And take care.